Welcome back, Interior Alaska. Joe Cook back in the sports seat for you this Monday evening with the weekend recap. There were some ups and downs in UAF sports over the holiday weekend. The Nanuq hockey team shut out the 19th-ranked Northern Michigan Wildcats 3-0 in an impressive performance on Friday night. Saturday, the Nooks had their brooms on hand, but the Wildcats were determined to get out of the Carlson Center with the win. At a 7-14 mark of the first period, Northern's Jake Baker scored on a power play to get the Cats an early lead. And about a minute later, the Nanuq, though, they answer with an even strength tally from Nolan Heisman's his fourth of the season, courtesy of Jared Linnell and Trevor Campbell. Then the Wildcats took advantage of some whistles. With 5 minutes left in the opening period, Barry Cabe converted the second power play for Northern. They would add another in the second and score their fourth power play goal just 1 minute into the third period. The refs let them play on Friday, but whistles were blown Saturday, calling the Nooks for 9 penalties. Northern only had 3. Northern wins 4-1 as the Wildcats and Nanuq split the series. On Friday, UAF went 2-for-2 on power plays. Northern went 4-for-9, scoring all of their goals with an extra man on Saturday. UAF is now 7-7 and tied for 7th in the WCHA with a 2-6 record. Saturday was the final day of the Mount McKinley Bank North Star Invitational Tournament. First back-to-back losses of the season for the UAF women after dropping their first two games in the Thanksgiving Classic. The UAF women's basketball team were aiming to get their first win of the tourney against the winless Colorado Christian Cougars. Colorado Christian, they were up 11 at the half, but in the second half, the Nanuqs had to rally. UAF chipped away, down by 1 with 11 minutes left. The Nooks went into beast mode on defense, getting 3 straight steals, scored on each turnover to swing momentum. As the Nooks went up by 10, UAF forced 21 turnovers and had 25 points off of Cougar miscues. The Cougars, led by Claire Paxson and Kate Lothan, who both had 16 points, brought their squad within 3 points late, but UAF made a last defensive stand and held on for a 68-66 win. Jordan Wilson had a game high 17 points and 4 steals in just 18 minutes for the Nooks on Saturday. She was named to the all-tournament team. Colorado Christian's Taylor Torres, Logan O'Farrell, and Shantiva Ashley of Augustana, and Emily Wendling and Samantha Zerzo complete the North Star all-tournament team. Saginaw Valley State went 3-0, and they are this year's North Star champions. The Nanuqs are now 6-2, and they will open their GNAC schedule at Seattle Pacific this Thursday. The Nanuq men's basketball team went through some heartbreak on Saturday. UAF lost to Holy Names on a layup at the buzzer and a 67-68 loss. The Nooks were ahead in the last 10 minutes of the game until the final play by Josh Kroom of Holy Names. Ashton Edwards had 14 points to lead the Nooks. Adam Griffin added 11. The UAF men's squad went 1-1 in the Notre Dame Day Namur Thanksgiving Tournament, defeating the host team on Friday. GNAC play begins for the men this Thursday as well on the road at Western Oregon. We wrap up this Monday sportscast with this week's I-5 Interior Top 5 Plays. Check them out.
At number 5, Kelly Lowe gets 5 steals against Saginaw Valley State on Thanksgiving, scoring 13 points in the process despite the 66-75 loss to the Cardinals. At number 4, Tyler Morley threads the needle to Marcus Bassar, who taps it in right on the doorstep in Alaska's win over Northern Michigan on Friday. At number 3, more from Friday night, Davis Jones records his second shutout of the year with 18 stops against the Northern Michigan Wildcats in a 3-0 victory. At number 2, check out the circus shot from Stephanie Toomson, which finds glass and ends up in the bottom of the net in a 66-63 victory over Colorado Christian in Saturday's North Star Invitational Finale. And number 1, the shot of the night on Friday. The captain, Colton Pareko, unloads and scores on the power play in the 3-0 victory over number 19 Northern Michigan on Friday night. To vote for the play of the week, click on your play on the I-5 poll on Webster11.com. You can also comment on the KTVF Facebook and YouTube posts and send a tweet to KTVF11 Sports on Twitter for your vote. The play of the week will be revealed this Friday.
The I-5 Sports Report is brought to you by Adient Orthopedic Physical Therapy.
And a final note, the West Valley North Pole hockey game scheduled for Tuesday has been canceled, but that will be rescheduled at a later date. But that'll do it for sports tonight. Mike Schultz is next with a very important weather forecast, so stay with us.